Woman refuses to move her car for a construction worker. Then karma quickly takes over. Some people have a level of entitlement that is truly out of this world. But as one rude driver learned, you can only get away with that for so long. In fact, she barely got away with her life. The day started like any other, but when it came time to pick up her kid from school, all hell broke loose. Foreman for hire. The stranger who shared the tale with the world was a construction worker and Redditor known by the username Barbecue Lunch. When he got hired as a foreman on a new house build, he had no idea that the job would come with such an intense obstacle. Surprisingly, his nemesis appeared in the form of a woman in a sedan. Up the hill. His day had already been tough up to that point, and this wasn't an ordinary house. It was elegant and large, classier than others in the neighborhood and tucked away at the top of the hill. Barbecue Lunch soon got very familiar with the steep incline, lugging around. Unfortunately, this meant that the contractors had to lug supplies all the way to the top of the hill from the driveway. It was a tiring trek and they couldn't afford any interruptions to their schedule. Thankfully, there was one rule on their side: no parking. There were two official no parking signs placed at the bottom of the hill, keeping the driveway clear and ready for functional use. But one passerby didn't care. The selfish stranger was more concerned about a buzzing location just down the hill from the construction site. Elementary school. Every afternoon, the workers heard a bell and the shrieks of excited children from an elementary school half a block from the bottom of the hill. Whether or not the foreman liked it, the area regularly ran wild with frenzied children and their parents. So far, so good. When construction began, parents were mostly compliant with the sign. It seemed to be doing its job. That is until one woman defied it. Even as she saw the foreman and his colleagues hiking up and down the steep slope, she pulled over to the curb. Parked anyway. Oblivious to their efforts, she parked right at the no parking sign, blocking the footpath up to the construction site. The foreman assumed that she must have missed the signage, so he walked over and kindly asked her to move. Chill pill. The woman immediately scoffed and replied, "I'll just be a few minutes, and your truck isn't here. Take a chill pill, dude." The foreman was taken aback, and unfortunately, this wouldn't be the worst of his problems. Pulling in. Just as the woman finished telling off the foreman, the lumber truck that was meant to pull in at that time arrived at the site. There was no place for him to unload all of the wood. The woman had to move, and fast. Still there, the foreman thought that the woman would surely understand at this point. After all, the truck she earlier brushed off had arrived right on time, so why was she still there? Windows up. Instead of leaving, the woman rolled up her windows and ignored the situation around her. The foreman waved until she rolled it down ever so slightly. She angrily yelled, "What?" He explained that the truck had to unload, but the driver wouldn't budge. Drive around. The woman insisted she wasn't moving until the school let out. "Can't you guys just unload around me? Jesus, it's not that hard," she spouted off. The foreman wasn't happy about it, but that's when an idea of his own entered the picture. Block for block. After working out an arrangement with the man driving the lumber truck, the foreman knew what had to be done. At his command, the lumber truck blocked her in next to the curb. However, the mean mom's reaction wasn't quite what they expected. Calling the police. She didn't even notice. The foreman, meanwhile, picked up his phone and called the police, at this time. "I wasn't trying to get her in trouble, I just wanted a record of why we were blocking part of the street so we didn't get in trouble with the city," he said. 30 minutes. The officer said that he would be there in 30 minutes, so the foreman had that much time to solve this. Before he could think of what to do next, the woman's kids arrived. In her hands. The woman couldn't even exit her car to greet her kid. She had to climb to the passenger seat side, and once she did, she barked at the foreman to move his car, but he replied that company policy forbade him from moving the truck while it's loaded. Waiting game. The woman would have to wait for it to be unloaded, but she definitely wasn't going to accept that, so she climbed back into her car and decided she would make a run for it, even though there was nowhere to go. Messy exit. After running over a porta potty, the woman's car got stuck on the sidewalk barrier. She didn't even come close to making it out, and the officer arriving on the scene watched it all happen. Needless to say, the crazed mother had broken a few laws. step out of the car. The officer asked her to step out. She lied and said the foreman gave her permission to park there. Unfortunately for her, the officer already knew the story. Made her bed. On top of being charged with reckless driving, destruction of property, and driving on a suspended license, the officer also towed the woman's car and arrested her. Her kid's grandmother was forced to pick him up. The foreman watched it happen, content that justice had been served. He shared a bold prediction with the rest of the construction crew. Lesson learned? I think next time she'll probably think twice about parking in a tow-away zone, if she ever gets a license again, he said. He soon shared the wild encounter online, where readers chirped up about their own brushes with parking karma. Impressively, some folks got their revenge without even having to get the law involved.